NetCDF and HDF5 are self-describing file formats that are used to store and organize large amounts of multidimensional scientific data. These file formats are used in many engineering and scientific fields that want a standard way to store data so that it can be shared. Unlike file formats with extensions such as docx, csv, or txt that can be accessed through a wide range of standard software, NetCDF and HDF5 files require specialized software to access them. In this video, you will learn how you can use import data live task in MATLAB to interactively explore the content of these files and import them into your workspace. Let's look at an example. We have a NetCDF file with interpolated snowcover data for the Northern Hemisphere. Our goal here is to determine the percentage of ground covered by snow. We have already downloaded this file to our current folder from the website of National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration Physical Sciences Laboratory. To view what's inside this NetCDF file, use the Import Data Live Task. Live tasks are simple point-and-click interfaces that can be added to a live script to perform a specific set of operations interactively. So while you could do this programmatically, the Import Data Live Task provides you with an interactive interface for exploring and reading a variety of file formats such as mat files, text, media, spreadsheets, and scientific data including NetCDF and HDF5. The Import Data Live Task can be found under the Task menu in the Live Editor. Now browse and select the downloaded NetCDF file. NetCDF files hold a complex structure of data, including variables, dimensions, and attributes, that makes it difficult to read and find specific data inside. The interactive live task displays the content of the file in an orderly format so that you can preview its structure and select the data of interest. Let's explore the file using the live task. Click on the data to view its detail on the side. The global attributes gives us a general sense of data contained in the file, including references. The file contains three dimensions, latitude, longitude, and time. Here we have a variable for each dimension, in addition to having them as dimensions, and a fourth variable named snowcover. The variable lat has a size of 90 and an attribute named units, which has value degrees north. Similarly, the time variable is used to represent the time in hours since the beginning of the year 1800. The snowcover variable spans the lat, long, and time dimensions and represents the monthly mean of snowcover at a particular point in the Northern Hemisphere, measured in percentage of ground covered by snow. Check the boxes for the data you wish to import. As we do this, the corresponding MATLAB code is automatically generated. At the bottom of the task, click Show Code to view this code. Now let's visualize the snow coverage. The live task outputs NetCDF data as a structure. First, extract the variable values from it. Next, from the task menu, choose Create Plot Live Task. The Create Plot Live Task provides you with a wide range of plotting options to choose from. Search for Geodensity Plot. Specify the required data. And you will get the visualization for the snow coverage in the first month. The darker regions in the plot show a high percentage of ground covered by snow when compared to the lighter regions. Let's take this even further and visualize how the snow coverage changes over a period. Use the code generated from the Create Plot Live task and animate the plot by looping through the data for all time samples. Here, you can see the snow coverage in Northern Hemisphere for every month and how it is changing over time. Now that you know how to import and explore a NetCDF file, visit the MATLAB documentation and learn more about the ways to interact with a NetCDF file and other scientific data formats such as HDF5. For more information on using import data live task, check out import data in MATLAB documentation.